Check.
The Maverick Podcast, UG. Man, I know it's been 2 weeks. I've been offline for a bit, but I'm back. Hudson Mugweri. He's always wanted to come on here and just, kill me with some...
And I make some noise, eh?
And you make some noise. That's good, Mike. How have you been?
I'm good.
Yeah. Talk to me, man. I know you're big in the sporting industry. Just take me through the shows you've been doing lately and everything.
Of course, I'm mainly now well versed with the Dugout.
Yeah.
That's on Next Radio and NBS Sport.
Yeah.
But we are coming back with the inbound show with Kawalia very soon. Mainly talking basketball, only local basketball.
Yeah.
And I'm well versed with local basketball. That's why people call me the Watch of Uganda.
The Watch of Uganda.
Yeah.
So I go way back with you, Hudson.
Yeah.
From, back at time, UCU, we played with the junior varsity team. Actually, we took over the junior varsity team from the Shem Bienchas. Those were great times to play basketball. I feel like the competition was heavy, great talent out there. How do you think the league has changed over time? And
going back in that team, I can't forget when 8 of us had graduated and we had games the next day. So we had quarterfinals against Gulu Hawks.
Yeah.
Our graduation was on Friday and we had quarterfinals against Gulu Hawks. Yes, we won the game, it was a 2-0. We swept the game, then went to the semifinals. We lost to Charging Rhino by half a basket. We went back to Mokono crying.
That was pain, man.
It was painful. I can't forget that time. It was so painful. And all of us had graduated. You know what it means? Like half of the team has graduated.
Yeah, it just means guys are moving on.
Yeah, guys are moving on. But wanted that silverware. Wanted that silverware. First, then we'd be like, let's move on. But
I believe that team was great.
It was great.
We really paved some good way for the coming Nikos.
True.
The Nikos, the younger boys, the Wundies that came in. Great team. They won the championship that next year.
And now that's it. What makes me proud and happy is seeing the stand coach of the UCU, Emmanuel Chigui, was our junior player, was like a young man by the time the first were the seniors. But when I see him there coaching the young lads, I'm like, this is impressive. This is what we need to see.
I think there's been great growth coming out there,
True.
Out of that program.
Yeah.
I feel like it's one program that should never have shut down.
True.
I really hope our Mukono counterparts can just bring it back, for the fans.
That's it.
The JV program was really great.
It was very great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How was your 2023 in sports?
It was so interesting.
Yeah.
Full of ups and downs. Uganda Cranes was qualifying for AFCON, which was a disappointment to me.
Mm.
With the group we're in, would have qualified. I was watching AFCON this year and I'm like, seriously, would have played some good football. Because we've got now players who really play football, not these players. Like how the for president said it's shitty football. Then the Gazelles going for AfroBasket and they were number 7 in Africa, beating up the top dogs in Kigali. It was a big achievement in the basketball world. We talk about the Shikranes going for the World Cup, coming out as number 5 into the World Cup, and recently they were having the different series of play Vitality League, which was so interesting in UK. All in all, talking about athletics, the guys breaking records, the so-called GOAT of Uganda, he's breaking records, of course. Yeah. Though he's injured, went for a marathon, he got injured, but we know he will come back and he does something in the Olympics. So all in all, It has been good.
I get you, man. Yeah. What are some of the new trends you're also seeing with sport going into 2024? I know it has evolved over the last, 10 years or decade. Yeah. What are some of the trends you're seeing in 2024 as a pundit?
Of late, we are updated as early as possible compared to those years. We get everything from the media. Later, updated as early as possible. Now you're seeing the Cricket Cranes qualifying for T20 World Cup. It is a big achievement for Uganda. And guess what? Just because the media didn't cover something, but like a mobile, it's now one of the sponsors of the Uganda Cricket Association, which is whereby the owner of Leica Mobile is a big fan of cricket.
Mm.
So it's a big plus for the Cricket Association. When you talk about basketball, AfroBasket qualifiers are going to take place.
Mm.
In Tunisia, we are in the group with Cape Verde as well.
Yeah.
No, I don't know why. I don't know why we're always in Cape Verde.
Cape Verde is such a nightmare, man.
Yeah. I don't know why we're always in Cape Verde.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think that we're supposed to start in late February, in Tunisia, hope and National Council of Sports gives the guys money as early as possible. I was told they're now playing games.
Okay.
But let them do something so that we go and qualify for AfroBasket. Because when we went for AfroBasketball last time, you saw what happened. We're beating Nigeria, and everyone was like, who are these guys? Yeah.
I feel you, man.
Yeah.
I also feel like one of the sports we have really left out here is rugby.
Yeah, rugby.
Rugby has taken the a rugby very big sevens. Growth.
Rugby you sevens, know? Then also the 15s.
Yeah.
We just recently winning up a big championship. Then also the sevens going recently in Dubai.
Yeah.
They had, of course, the tournament was somehow shaky, but I would say give credit to the ladies. The ladies pulled off something. They played some good rugby.
Mm.
Yeah, the men, I give credit to them because they've been there in Africa. They've been representing Africa for some good time, and they're still representing Africa because they're among the top three countries in Africa.
Yes, sir.
So I know they can pull off something any time and a day.
I believe rugby has matured.
It has matured.
I believe even from the way it's shaping trends, even trends in outlets going out, it's shaping occasions, you know. People are going out just because of rugby.
From the 23 fans to now big fans.
Yeah.
To now it's fans.
Really, it's really big.
Because when you look at someone, can tell you're going for a game, I'm like, yes, which game? Pirates, Heathens. When can we go? Be like it's on Sunday. They're eager to just watch the game.
I'd say locally too. It's one big event. It's one big occasion that you just can't miss out.
Yeah,
I'll give credit
to the sponsors.
Mm.
They pulled off something. Not forgetting the clubs themselves.
Yeah.
The clubs are trying to push so hard as well. You look at how Edens does their thing, how Paris does their thing. Look at Cobbs. You look at Rams. You look at Entebbe, Mongas.
Yeah.
All the big clubs. Look at Hippos as well. It's so interesting. Now, remember when we went for Uganda Cup? I had me thinking. Rugby sevens when they went to Tororo, then they saw shock. They saw a shock of a team from Tororo beating them. They were like, "What's this?" You know, which was so interesting. Everyone was like, "That team had rugby player, had the guys. They wouldn't get tired." Yeah,
interesting. I feel like 2024 has a lot packed in store for us. I don't want you to rush. I know we've had a long day today, both of us having off our 9-to-5s, but making it here just to have the conversation of the week, have the YouTube of the week. I feel like, let's not rush. I don't want you to rush me. Just take your time. What do you think 2024 has in store for us?
First and foremost,
yeah,
I would say football-wise, the sport has brought back the fans. Because as we speak, locally, when you see the stadiums, they're now kind of full. The local football is growing every now and then.
Mm.
Now, I'm going to watch the KCCA versus Bull game at 6 p.m. Of course, they introduced the night football at Chiten and at Philip Omondi Stadium, which is so interesting. Local football is really, really improving. You really see talent is in Uganda now. Compared to those days where I'd be like, locally, these guys just play their normal thing. But it is developing at a higher peak. It is changing. Even in terms of funds, the players are now getting real good money. A player can tell you, I would rather play in Uganda than playing in a country where I'm being benched. They want playing time. They want to be exposed. They want to go to be called or to be someone on the national team, which is something so interesting. I would give credit to Vipers, to KCCA, to Express, to AC Villa. Or of course, the old clubs are AC Villa, Express, KCCA. You know, they're doing a good job. Then got teams like Chitara. The way they've come up, it is one of the big teams now in Uganda.
Mm.
If you're watching football, you have to be like, there's Omed of Chitala, there's Frank Zago of Chitala. You know, you're naming players,
By club.
By club. There's Chris of Chitala, the goalkeeper. Be like, he has got like these four clean sheets in this season, which is so interesting. You know, so literally, I would say football has changed in Uganda. And with now, people can sit at their homes and watch the game live on Sanyuka TV or Fofa TV. It is a big, big improvement when it comes to the football in Uganda. Even now, the ladies' football, I follow it compared to those days. I follow it. I'm like, of course, Kampala Queens is there. It's owned by the Fofa president. That's Magogo. Then you've got Uganda Matters as well. You've got UCU. The ladies are also playing football. You've got also Kawempe playing good football. You'll be like, wow, the sport is growing and every now and then. So generally, I would say football is growing. The big league also, it's growing. So you see sponsors coming in, sponsoring the big league now, like BetPower is sponsoring the big league. It is a big, big plus. It's an achievement in football. Yeah.
I feel that talking about sponsorship, so I think, how big do you think, you know, different companies, you name it, from whatever sector, I believe, how big do you think they're going to earn from sport this year? Because the platforms are there for them to really reap the benefit from investing in clubs. Mm. I think it's going to be also an eye-opener for me, you know?
Yeah, it's actually, when you look at how MTN snagged that deal of Airtel from, from, let me say, the FIFA deal from Airtel. Yeah. They show that, you know what, Airtel is getting from football, let's all come in and get more. Because MTN was the first sponsor. Then they pulled out. Airtel got from them. And now the competition between the telecoms is something so big. You know, if I'm Airtel, I'd be like, you know what, now, of course, I've got the Kabaka run. It's on. Mm. Can I go into basketball or rugby? Because the fans are there. And I'm going to benefit as a brand. I'll benefit something as a brand. Because when they make these deals, there's something they benefit from. Because MTN doesn't just sponsor. They're as in FUFA, as in the Ghana Cranes. No, there's something they get from them. Look at Nao Special, they're doing that thing as well.
Personal football.
With rugby and football as well.
Yeah.
Okay, it is something so big. Mm-hmm. Now, the fights we are seeing in rugby between Cobs and the rugby union is because of Guinness, which wants to come and sponsor Cobs as well. We've seen now KCB coming to sponsor Cobs. I'm like, wow. It's now called KCB Cobs. It is a big, 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 big thing.
Yeah.
Now banks are coming in. After KCB seeing what Stanbic is doing with Pirates, they're like, you know what?
Let's get in the action. Yeah.
After seeing what Platinum is doing with
the Heathens.
They're like, you know what? Let's get in. One of the big clubs and the old clubs in the Ugandan rugby. It is something we're seeing, something so big. Though you haven't seen it in basketball, apart from housing finance coming in from Deje, it is.
I think that was big.
Yeah, that was big. That was big. Housing finance coming in from Deje. Yeah. Of course, for City Oil, they're taken care of by Cafe Javas.
That's the standard.
But still, they need another sponsor somewhere into their camp.
I think that will solidify the dominance of Ugandan basketball. Speaking of basketball, man, now that we are into the topic, a sport that we are very familiar with, man, I've always wanted to host someone that can really break down for me what talent lies within Division 3 and Division 2. Those are two amazing leagues. I feel like they are under-sponsored. I feel like they are underlooked in by FUBA.
Yeah.
I just don't know, man. Where are we going? Because this is a talent pool where kids are picked from. You've seen the likes of JT coming down from Div 3, coming to Div 2, giving us a whirlwind of a season, coming into the NBL. They're now 2-0 in the NBL.
True.
You know, that's the work of somebody. Livingstone at that, you know, the Pies said, okay, this is our baby, let's carry it.
Yeah.
You know, from Makerere, the pool court. Let's carry our baby Livingstone. Look where they are now. These are individuals that are carrying teams.
Mm.
And right now, if the league does not get into the back of the Division 3 and Division 2, Division 1 won't be as interesting
as it is now. Because the rule of 4 international players also doesn't favor the top flights. So they have to go down to look for the players. When you look at JT, I think they got 2 players from the lower division, from Kumba Marines and also from the Luzila team, best team.
Mm.
I'm forgetting its name. Veg.
Veg.
Yeah, they got 2 players from there. Mm. Meaning they're adding something. They saw talent. They saw talent. They're like, you know what? Let's pick these guys who are talented. Under 18. Most of the under 18 kids, some of them play in lower division. I hope so. Or from different teams. Right now, the best player in under 18 is called Edwin. He plays for Charging Rhino, but he's joining here for this year. He's under 18. You know him. He's a young kid.
Okay.
Yeah, he's one of the talented kids I've ever seen, and he's so humble. Yeah, it's so come, it's so, but he's in charging Rhino. Mm. But I'm sure after 2 or 3 years, he'll be on the national, on the silver backs national, senior national team. If he continues like that.
For me, it's just always.
When you look at the likes of Bismarck, the kind of basketball he plays, the points he puts up, even if he's versing a big team, he give you 15 points and above and 10 rebounds, you'll be like, wow, what is this? Moses Mugisha, the big man of our savior, he came from Kampala University. It was a lower division team. And he's dominating the league. Yeah, he's dominating the league. I would request FUBA to take back the league to where they had the lower division committee. It was something so different. And the league by that time was organized. So organized and so competitive. Compared to how it was last year.
I've always felt like, yes, you know, like this top flight. You're going for a top flight game tonight.
Yeah.
UCU and...
Again, it's KU Titans.
KU Titans, yeah. You're going for a top flight game tonight. I feel like a Division 1 game
should be
headlined right before the ladies' game.
Yeah.
Because now what that does for the stadium is it's going to bring people out of office.
True.
I kid you not. Get any game from Division 1 before the ladies' game before the main ladies' game, it's going to be a sellout for you.
True.
But I don't think a strategy like that is in place.
It's not in place.
Because imagine you have, let's say, what are teams right now? Let's say Chinkumba Marines and Tropical Royals.
Yeah.
Going at it before the main ladies' game. That's a big game. Guys will leave office and say, man, I have to watch this game.
Mm.
I don't know. I feel like that can be a crowd puller.
It can be a crowd puller.
But it's underlooked.
It's also exposure. Because scouts, they'll be like, there's a young man from Nkuma Marines. This is after this season, or in the first half of this season, can he join my team? You know? But now, we are contradicting. There's a game, Stoyle is going to plug against Power. Then there's a lower division game also taking place at YMCA. You're seeing that. If the games are in one venue, I would say games are like in one venue, there you can easily spot talent. But some of us who love basketball, be like on a Saturday, let me go watch lower division. In the morning, then later I go watch the top flight.
The top flight. Mm.
Yeah. Others are like, but what happens in lower division? They start watching lower division in playoffs when this league is done.
Yeah.
Top flight is done.
Yeah.
And then someone tells you, man, lower division is so interesting. I'm like, hey, so you didn't know lower division is so entertaining than even the top flight. Because top flight, you know, all is going to play against. Let me say, like Res Life, that's a sure win for Oilers. But in our division, you can't know he's going to win. He's going to win. Because I remember the way JT Jaguars fought with the number 8. You know, remember, actually, an example is I Hoops was number 1 in regular season, but they were beaten.
Yeah, I know. It's so funny. But
it's so funny. The cast of division is so competitive.
The number 1 seed in the divisions is so far. It's a monkey. It's a big monkey. Man.
Yeah.
I just don't know how teams shake that off. But coming to what you were saying, that the quality and the beauty of those divisions, I believe, is what is going to shape the growth and development of the top flight.
True.
I just think if we put a bit of more focus in terms of the spotlight.
Yeah.
I think we can make some wins there. I think we can make some wins there. Any new trends that you're seeing in 2024?
Of course,
I know
now,
we've been into basketball, but any other, what are you seeing?
Of course, the chic rings are just from England.
Mm-hmm.
And seriously, we need to take netball serious in Uganda. Because what I saw when those girls left Wales to England, when they stopped somewhere, the autographs they were signing. I'm like, Bagala we see every day on court. Like, that's Bagala, it's normal. But doesn't she's taken as what? As a superstar. Here we take them for granted. Yeah.
I hear you. I feel like I like that you're big on women in sport.
Yeah.
It's a great thing to see, man.
True.
Yeah. What about how do... You know, in this day and age, we are being inclusive and diverse. Anything happening around persons with disability, what's going on in that side? Do you also venture into some media work in that side of the community?
Of course, apart from wheelchair basketball, which happens once in a while, some of the players actually had an exhibition game in Rwanda. I think earlier this year, I think late last year or earlier this year, I was talking to one of the organizers who was telling me it was something so interesting, man. It was something so interesting seeing wheelchair basketball taking place in Uganda. Most of the, and like five players from Uganda are busy dominating the league. Wow. That means we have a lot of, we have talent here in Uganda. Wow. Okay. Whereby if the government can sit down and strategize properly, be like, you know, let's make a better plan for the sport in Uganda, the sports in Uganda, how far would go? We'd be very far. But with the talk of like they're going to construct the sports complex at Lugogo, we might see something so different. We might see the fraternity growing at a higher peak. And you would see most of the scouts coming together to get players. Because sit down, look at high school football sports, the football, the netball, the basketball, the volleyball, high school only. Recently, they were playing the Elite League for under 15s in Ginger SS. And someone was telling me, man, these kids are talented. I'm like, wow, this is interesting. Yeah. Which means there's talent in Uganda.
Yeah.
But the issues, the facilities are very few. And now some of the kids don't have that exposure. Yeah. If you have the good exposure, that's why I'll give credit to whoever, a media person doing his or her job to make sure someone is seen out there. I'll give credit to them. They're doing an incredible job.
Great. For me, big shout outs to you guys, man. You're always everywhere. You find a way to be everywhere.
Actually, you know, I apart from basketball, most of the games I pay. I'd be like, you know what, let's support. If I have some, let me pay. I go watch football. I go watch cricket. I go watch rugby. Yeah. Because the 10K or 20K you pay, it's maybe a player's allowance. You know? What if a player gets injured? They top up that money to get treated player, water or something. It helps these players.
I still see a big, personally, in 2024, I see the future I see for sport in Uganda is business, like turning sport into business. I see a lot of business growth for sports.
True.
I see a lot of return on investment for people that started investing in sport even 15 years ago.
Yeah.
It would be hard for you to just think that you're going to make a buck or make a dollar tomorrow, but there are people that have invested in this sport
and they're still 10, investing
15, 20 years, still investing. Yeah. I feel like for me, this is the year people start to reap what they've
out,
been
out
sowing.
Of the sport.
I see it across all sports.
Apart from the saga of Aruahil, Aruahil saga, where the guy sold off the club and he said he wasn't getting something from it. But if I was him, I would have been patient. Like how the Melindwas are, like how these other guys are, they're patient. You know what? Let's be patient. Still, once in a while, we can get money out of it. Now look at Express. After selling one of their players, Kambale, they fined the club and FIFA was like, you know what? Those guys have to pay you money. Now get their money. You know, one or two. You sell one or two players in those professional clubs, getting money. The money I'm sure Melindo got from Manzuki was some good money.
Yeah.
Now right now, when I look at professional players moving around, you talk to them. Like they're like, my man, I have to keep myself fit. This is where I earn from. And I'm getting good money. They're driving, they're constructing houses, they're doing other things. They're entrepreneurs as well. Mm-hmm. Literally, the ratio that, you know what, we are developing. In today's new vision, they are showing the boxers how much they earn annually.
Yeah.
And I saw a guy earning 100 ma per year. I'm like, oh. This is serious.
Oh, that's crazy.
This is serious. I'm like, the guy's earning this good man, and he has like a fashion shop. He's doing something also as well into the gym sector. Not only is he into boxing, but he's doing other things.
He's diversifying.
And as well as an entrepreneur as well. I'm like, oh, this is massive. This is big.
Man, that's the sport in Uganda. That's where I see the sport going this
year.
But I believe. So what's next for you today, man? I know you are going somewhere. Caught you a bit unawares and off guard, but you know you always had to pay. You wanted to pay me a visit.
Yeah.
I had to pay the Maverick Podcast UG a visit.
True.
Just thanks. Big shout out to all our subscribers. I just wanted us to have a sports segment. Just a bit of what I like to do in my life. And having a friend a partner that we used to study together back in 09 in Mukono, an alumni. Mm. It's always great to have you here, bro, and I appreciate you taking the time off.
Thank you very much.
What are you doing tonight? You know, you seem up and down, you have your soccer boots.
It is just I'm going to watch football after watching KCF versus Bull. Bull is topping. Topping the league right now. It's ahead by, I think, 2 points. Vipers number two. And then, of course, KCF somehow struggled, but it's a big game in Uganda. That's a big game in Uganda. Yeah. Then after that, of course, I'll go at Lugogo, watch basketball, the University Derby. You see, Uganda versus KU Titans. Then, as I'm watching football, I think I'll be watching African Cup as well.
Oh, all right.
There's Angola versus Nigeria. That's the game to watch.
I gave you my prediction for the final. I told you it's Cote d'Ivoire, Angola.
Cote d'Ivoire, Angola.
Those Angola kids are really looking good out there.
Okay, let's enjoy that.
After tonight,
we'll go.
It's been my guy, Hudson Mugweri, the Maverick Podcast, UG. Like, share, subscribe. It's been the YouTube of the week. Thanks to my brother here for showing up today. I also gotta go. I want to run and catch the Kinganda experience here at Motive. Peace, guys. Catch you later. Catch you next week.